So I'm Nathanael Lesage, and I'm a 3D artist and animator on Nanotale at Fishing Cactus. Fishing Cactus is an indie video game studio based in Belgium, known as the studio behind Epistory, a typing chronicle. We are currently 18 and 8% work on Nanotale typing chronicle, the successor of Epistory.
I'm Quentin Guillon, I'm a 2D artist. So Nanotale is a typing game with a RPG aspect, with a very colorful environment, and you are Rosaline, a novice archivist, and you use 2D plants and some creatures into this colorful world.
I'm using Houdini for the animation. It's pretty simple. It's like the other animation software. Houdini has the same tool for the creation of custom rig for the animation. So in Nanotale, I'm create custom rigging for each character we have. And I animate it with a keyframe animation. Houdini bring us the SGA system. So it's very cool to have the flexibility on it. It's easy to work with a work in progress model. Since we use an SGA when we have the final model, it's simple to just skin it, and it will reverberate on each file. For example, in Nanotale, I'm working with Rosaline, the main character. A few months after the final rigging, I had to add books. And it was easy to add bones, parameters, the switcher, do the animation with the interaction between Rosaline and the book on all the animation files. So it's pretty powerful, and it's a game time.
Procedural assets are very great for the level design, because level designers work with a very basic block out to build the maps. With the AGA, we can have a lot of flexibility, and we can decorate the scene very soon in the process to have a good feeling with the game as soon as possible. We can readapt the environments with the new blockout. There is a lot of flexibility with the AGTA. We export a curve. In Unity, we edit the curve to have a nice shape for making some, for example, some routes. We have a lot of woods and some platforms. Also, we have rock walls, and we can have any shape we want. That's great to build very fast the forest or some rock fields and something like that. It's valuable because the procedural workflow allows to save a lot of time. I think it's also a great tool because you can build your own library of tools. Any studio can have its own tool library.
The only advice I could give is don't be shy to test and practice Houdini. It has a lot of video and tutorial, a good community to help you. After seeing the strength and the power of Houdini, we don't want to do another game without Houdini.